Okay, we will bring our committee, the whole meeting, to order. Just before we begin this, I want to say out loud, way to go Blizzard, way to go Blizzard, way to go Blizzard. I think it was, they outscored them.
14-3. Yeah, not that anybody was counting.
I thought it was 2, 14-2. They got an extra goal, I didn't realize.
3 on Friday.
Unbelievable. Anyway, so away they go down south to finish the butt kicking. Good for them. Job well done. We just get to keep you around for a few more weeks then, eh?
Couple more weeks.
Yeah, okay, well, that's the good news there. That's great. I'm glad team's doing well. All right. Let us move along. Planning and development subdivision approval 3.1.
So if you recall, some time ago, we were approached by some residents in the adjacent area requesting to purchase property from the town. We sold the property as per usual practice at assessed value. However, before we could continue with the sale of the property, it had to be subdivided. So this is an application for subdivision, and we require resolution of approval, of conditional approval, which would require a plan of survey, easement agreements, and taxes being up to date, all costs at applicant's expense. So at our next meeting, we will be bringing forth a resolution, which basically provides a conditional approval for the subdivision to complete the sale.
Okay, and so all the ducks in a row, though, right?
Yep.
Okay, perfect. Anybody have a problem with that?
So we're good to bring forward a resolution?
Item number 4.1, delivery certificate of taxi cab license.
So every time a taxi cab business changes hands, the town must approve the transfer of the license or delivery license. So we are recommending a resolution to transfer taxi ownership from Nini to Isfeld. And that would require a resolution.
Amazing that we have to do that. Okay, I can't imagine anybody have an issue with that. Perfect.
Good. Just to provide additional information, we are only permitted so many taxi cabs within the community, so that's why they come through us too.
Yes, yeah, going from one to another, so there's not going to increase the number of cabs. AMM resolution, 4.2.
So we have a lot of discussion that I would like to have with council here. The flat tax or the base tax, there's on your agenda, there's information attached. The education tax, we talked about bringing that forward at AMM level. Right now there's a standing policy with it. We also discussed the VLTs. It was a suggestion of council that we go after the province about VLTs. It was recommended that a letter be sent instead of a resolution in hopes of getting a faster response. And the CDI funding, we reviewed this with the CFO, and we don't believe that there's any issue with the process. It's a matter of just asking the question. So I would like any discussion from council.
Okay, so let's start at the top and work our way down. It was brought forward last year at AMM from the city of Flin Flon, and they apparently were quite successful, but it's time for us to provide another resolution, and this needs to go province-wide so that we can have the right to do as we please with the money that is collected, or at least on our way. We need to have this flat tax. We need to have this flat tax. Our community is not growing, and this is going to help us. There, I've got it going. Let me sit back and watch. Pardon.
So if I can just add to this, this is a standing policy note. This resolution is consistent with AMM policy and will not be brought forward to the convention floor unless requested by delegates.
I'm not getting that done.
So it's just sort of status quo going forward, no change? Is that the sense, I guess?
It's already there. So we just support the resolution. So we ask them to bring it back so that we can bring it back to the convention floor.
Okay. I thought it wasn't ready.
No.
Are we in agreement with what their resolution is here?
Yeah, that's my big. So I'm sure we've all read it before anyway.
The second attack.
Jack has almost done. He was going to say something.
So this is different than the way things are set up now with the special services levy. This would be to actually be able to do a straight across the board flat tax in whatever way we see fit.
Yes.
I'm fairly confident they're going to want to know a dollar figure. And I think that we better be prepared to have an answer for them.
We had that discussion before, right? How are you going to sign? We don't know. I don't know what the no offer is. I disagreed. I don't think they're going to want to know.
You don't think so?
Leave it up
good.
To us.
That's fine. We
talked about that before, Mike.
Yeah, I mean, I think at the end of the day, what's going to happen is they're going to say the core services. I mean, and we've talked about this. The core services are going to be the portions that they look at and say, okay, so if everybody gets fire service, if everybody gets protective services, then those are the amounts that you can use to apply base tax. You know, I mean, they're not going to say simply take whatever revenue you generated and divide it by 1,500 properties and off you go, right? It's not going to be that for sure. So I'm fine with the standing resolutions as are presented here for the base tax.
Anybody else have any comments?
I'm good with it.
That's that one. Let's go on to the next one.
So everybody's fine with the standing resolution?
Everybody's yes. Fine with the standing resolution. Education Funding Model Task Force.
So basically what this has been on file and supported by the standing resolution since 2013. There was the standing policy and has now gone further than just a resolution, and it's become a position paper and can be reviewed online. If council's okay with this, then a resolution is not required. If council wishes to sponsor a resolution specifically regarding the collection aspect, then it would not be considered a standing policy and we have to do a new resolution. So if you're referring to the specific collection, then we need a resolution. If not, if you're wanting to just continue as per the resolution, we need it as is.
When you're referring to collection of, are you referring to the removal part of the tax levy, educational tax levy?
That's the question.
Yeah, if you look at the Education Funding Model Task Force position paper that they had here, it was further be it resolved that the AMM lobby the province of Manitoba to ensure the task force review includes such options but not limited to the following: removing the educational tax levy from the municipal tax bill, funding the entire educational tax system from general revenue, ensuring that all taxpayers are taxed on their ability to pay, a full and complete review to determine if amalgamation can reduce duplication in services and create efficiency by having less school divisions in Manitoba, and a complete review of the equalization payments and how they currently do not reflect in a fair and equitable manner in the current growth and declining student divisional populations, creating an unfair burden for the funding education taxes of all Manitobans who own property. Pretty much says what we've been fighting for.
It's exactly what it we've been fighting for. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. So we wouldn't require any resolution.
Nope.
It's a standing policy.
Yeah. Next one, PLT revenue.
This has come up in some discussion we've had as for the per capita. There's also a standing resolution, and it's basically, it's not to be brought forward to the convention floor unless requested by delegates. And it was basically be it resolved that the AMM lobby the province of Manitoba to devote 15% of VLT revenue to address addictions, poverty, and homelessness in communities that have a high level of social problems created as a result of misuse of VLTs and abuse of alcohol. They had recommended us sending a letter instead of a resolution as it may get a quicker response.
What does that mean?
Because we had expressed concerns about conditional starting in 2013. There's not a standing resolution regarding the social issues that emanate from the misuse of it. So they basically said if we have any further concerns, bring forward a letter because you'll get a faster response because this is already a standing policy. You're like what?
I guess the thing I'm thinking about is, you know, looking ahead to the convention floor when these things are brought forward. And this would not be brought forward because this is just a standing policy note that perhaps maybe we do want to have time for another discussion on it. I mean, the social woes of our community, more importantly our community and our province of course, but our community is, near as I can tell, there's upwards of $0 being invested in it. And our own province scoops out millions of dollars a year out of our community to go help the bottom line in the province instead of it being spent where it should be spent, is in the community. Those that can least afford to use these machines and drink the alcohol are the ones that are drinking the alcohol and using the machines. There's mental health issues involved, and someone needs to step up to the plate. And that's where the revenue is for that. So do we want to make that statement in Brandon this fall, or do we want it as a standing policy?
I think we make the statement, because if you look at the PAW and OCN, we have 320 VLTs, roughly. That probably puts us at the highest per capita percentage in the country, maybe.
That doesn't include the casino.
That
right?
does.
No, oh, that doesn't
include everything. But at the same time, you're right, right? Millions of dollars are going out. And what's coming back? Then it's getting spread equally across all communities, and that's not fair.
And it seems the House always does.
I don't know exactly how the funding is when it comes to the First Nations communities, if they do it the same way.
It's 90-10. It's
completely opposite of ours.
But you can still calculate roughly.
We can use theirs even though...
I could show you.
It's revenue. It's
no, I mean by using their numbers in the amount of VLTs.
I think we can.
I think it proves it. I mean, for one community, right? It's we're facing the same social issues.
I don't, yeah.
Nope, not disputing that. Yeah. I'm just asking a question.
I just don't want to be one community when it's convenient. Okay? You clear?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Item 4.3, assistance program to develop a forestry stabilization grant project.
This was actually more of an internal thing, like through our administration and management, rather than going to AMM.
Did I? I didn't
CDI
see it fourth time.
No, you guys are on the same one, right? Yeah.
CDI
funding. AMM resolutions that I went on to 4.3.
Yeah, there really isn't a funding application is what we're seeing. There's not an application process.
Sorry.
That's okay.
Yeah. It's been dealt with, right?
Yeah.
Basically.
So there's no need to be bringing forward a resolution at AMM.
All right. Sorry.
And I don't know if it's too late, but, and I apologize on Friday, I was just confused about meeting times. Can we bring forward another resolution, or is it too late to do that now?
You can still bring forward.
Because one of the things and I don't know if it's brought up the convention, but our new Build Canada fund, like the funding we got for LaRose Avenue, or these guys got for LaRose Avenue, it's a 30-30-30 split.
Right.
We should be pushing provincially and federally for it to be a 40-40-20 split. Because as soon as we get into it, 2 years on, we're doing what we see now, and I don't think we're the only community that, you know, in construction, everything's going up, and then we keep eating that. That would help offset, at least soften that blow.
And sing that song all day.
Yeah.
So I'm okay with doing, sorry, I'm just repeating.
Yeah.
Bringing forward a resolution to the AMM to consider that the New Build Canada Fund move from a 40-40, or move from a 30-30-30 split to 40-40-20 to offset infrastructure renewal in communities.
Yeah.
We're good to go with that, everyone?
We are, I believe.
Sure.
Okay. Yes. Now 4.3. Sorry.
So basically what you see here is a draft bylaw that we want to bring forward for first reading at the next meeting, and this is for the town support in the sustainable forest industry.
Any discussion? We are good to go. 4.4, water to taxes transfer.
We have 100...
Okay. I'm just looking at it. Just a quick question about 3C in that bylaw. You know, by my calculations, that we're projecting out about 18 months from when the company started, that we expect to sit down and get a report. Is that reasonable?
I think it's we're looking at an annual report, not?
Right. So they're in their first year. So by the time they finish it and get some closure on the year, it's usually, you know, 15 to 18 months before.
Yeah. So I I can tell you that I'm going to invite CKPI to come visit us and talk to us about a presentation that I saw last week that was called Their First 100 Days. And I think that's a... Is this on an agenda later?
Yep.
Okay, I'll bring it up then. We need to get the message out what they brought to to that meeting.
Yeah, so, no, I just wanted to clarify what our expectation was as to when a first meeting would be coming.
Yeah, I mean, I think it makes sense, given that we're at our budget point here, that, you know, we make it clear to them that, you know, if they want us to include this annually in the budget, they need to get here. Fiscal year end for them is December 31st. Then, you know, we should be expecting to hear from them with how the year's gone and what they project for the upcoming year, like now, and in advance of now when we're about to pass the budget, so that we are able to speak to what the situation is with the industry and what the situation is with respect to the grant and how we expect it's going to be successful. So, I mean, I think, I don't know, I think we did we not make a request, Randy, send an email out asking for an update?
I think that's what kind of triggered your community meetings, that's why they're doing that.
No, but I think as a council, we wanted to hear in camera
from
the company,
because
this is the town's investment. I think what we were looking for was a council meeting, or at least a presentation to council on a general one, if that's what they want to do, which we should do for the public in an open session, but as well perhaps an in-camera session where we get a chance to ask questions where they might be able to provide additional information if it's in camera.
Okay.
And in January?
Well, I mean, December 31st is year end, but, you know,
yeah, but I mean, they've been out there since the 10th of November, or December the 2nd, actually, I guess it was, and I would like all of you to hear what I heard, and I think we need to hear that. We need to hear where they're at, what they're doing, and where they're headed. Yes.
So you would like meeting with them before we go to a public meeting?
Well, no.
Before we have it, yes. I do.
Okay, fair enough. But I mean, that's what, 7 days away or something?
No, I think so.
Do you mean the financial plan public hearing?
Mm-hmm. Oh, sorry. No.
Oh.
There's coming up later in the agenda, there's a public meeting to maybe take that forward to.
Okay, yeah. Well, definitely. Yeah, in advance of that, for sure. Yeah.
Okay.
But for us, if I can go ahead, is if we want to meet in camera with CKPI annually, it should be prior to our budget deliberations or ongoing. At the end of January, they'll have a good idea. They might not have audited statements, but they'll know exactly where they are. So for us to say, let's meet in December or November, that's great. It'll give us a State of the Union up, but it's not the data we're looking for. It's different, I think, from what you're requesting, because that was a great presentation. Everyone needs to hear that.
Yeah.
But I think we need to hear a little more than that about what's going on, and they're not going to be able to answer questions until they have data. And I mean, you can
maybe
clarify
that.
That's gonna be January.
That's why I say January.
So we should set, like, there's two things happening here, right? There's one for budget, for what we're talking about in the bylaw. It should be every January and February. That's roughly when we're going to meet, sometime there. And then what Jim's request is separate.
Let me just rephrase everything so we're crystal clear. When this council decided that they were going to invest in this for stabilization, it was with the understanding that we would meet with them on an annual basis, and that they would come to us with information on how the year was and what their projections are in the future. And so that hasn't changed one bit, and that meeting should take place either the third or fourth week of January, first week of February at the latest, of each year that we have this, that we're involved in this. What I'm talking about in terms of a town meeting is that, I'll look right in the camera, what I heard was really good news. And I want to make sure that that news gets out to the community for those who are concerned about it being a very short-term thing that's going on out there. So I want, it'll help our community. An annual meeting with these guys that need to come and talk to us.
So do we make it easier and clarify in number C in saying this meeting to be held by mid-February in each year?
Why don't we say March 1st of each year? That could be 60 days after the end of their year, and then it's not like, you know.
Have we asked them when's a reasonable time? And the reason I ask that is because we're looking them to forecast operations and finance for the upcoming year. And when you get into putting your finance out there, you generally want to know that you're putting out appropriate, accurate, and complete stuff, not...
They don't operate like a government. We don't do our budget in January.
They're way ahead of the edge.
No.
It's on December 1st, the budget's already done.
this is a private corporation.
Yeah.
They know what they're doing 3 years from today.
What? Within 30 days...
Like us?
Yeah.
No.
Certainly they're able to, if it's not audited statements or whatever, they're certainly able to provide us with legitimate and accurate data by mid-February. And if they say, well, that's too short, you know what, guys, you're asking us to invest, sorry, we got a timeline too?
Sure.
Work on it, bring us the best you can, whatever.
So our budget, we're concerned over, that's why we're asking them to meet with us.
They're not the answer.
Sure, our budget,
Yeah, absolutely, so.
Okay, so are we okay with mid-February then?
Well, I'm fine to put a March 1st deadline.
Leave it the way it is.
Call it the second meeting in February.
Second meeting of council in February?
So I might deal ready.
I didn't really expect specifics other than I wanted to get a feel for whether council was gonna be next month, saying, well, why haven't they reported to us or something?
Well, don't get me wrong, I expect that really quickly here, we should get a presentation from them. I mean, we're about to pass a budget that includes a grant for them, so.
Yeah.
Let's knock on the door and ask for a presentation. It won't be hard for them to come up with it because they've just done a big one here, a big presentation for that summit, so.
Okay.
So the bylaw we're bringing forward for first reading will reflect a change in saying that this will, the meeting be held by the second meeting of council in February of each year.
Correct. We're all good? Warrant or taxes transfer, 4.4.
We have over $175,000 in outstanding water accounts. In accordance with the Municipal Act, that we have the opportunity to pass a resolution to add these to taxes. So what we want to do is anything that is outstanding as of March 31st, we want to add to taxes. So we would require a resolution.
Is this an unusual amount?
No.
Unbelievable.
So this is pretty common. I must say in the last 2 years, we've been really up to par on adding our outstanding utilities to taxes.
Does anybody have an issue with this? I don't.
No.
Okay. Notification has also been given, like a lot of the times when it's a landlord, we follow all the process so that the landlords are aware.
Okay, Federation of Canadian Municipalities Defense Fund.
So FCM has come to us and asked us to look at, I guess it's not a, you don't have to, but I believe they're asking for our support in providing them with some financial assistance as it relates to legal fees, et cetera, moving forward. This is in addition to our membership. We've never been asked for this, to contribute to a legal fund. However, when we base it on our population, the cost is only $129.65. I think the merit at the table here is that we strongly support the FCM. And this is $130.
I couldn't agree more.
Okay.
So I would request that we move forward with a resolution.
It's okay with everyone? Yes, Brian.
So we're changing our budget. We're going to be talking about next Monday by doing this, right?
It's $130. I'm sure I could find it somewhere in my budget stuff.
Yeah, but this is okay. So the money already is there. We
have money to organizations. We have a little bit of an extra fund. This would fall under that.
So why did it have to come here then?
Because you don't have a budget yet, and this is something new that we've never dealt with.
So it's not covered by the insurance.
So there's line okay, so it's not a line item in our
nope.
We have to approve all spending. Okay. Anything else? Town hall meeting. I see that's on the agenda.
So we just had the discussion about having a town hall meeting regarding Canadian craft paper. Do we want just this issue at this community meeting, or do we want to discuss any other issues at this community meeting?
Any and all.
And are there any other issues council wants on there, and what are we looking at time-wise?
I think we could use this almost like an annual report. Like we have some, you know, like we have the CDC, we have the Destination Marketing Committee, we have, you know, Kelsey Recreation has changed from Kelsey Recreation Committee into just like a recreation department. So I think it could be a good time to do like a little bit of an annual report and update and, you know, this is what
State of the
done
Union.
And, yeah, exactly.
Yep. Thompson does a State of the Union every year.
We used to do that too.
Yeah?
Yeah. And you'll find this hard to believe, but you know, a good number of local citizens would come out to beat up the mayor on an annual basis.
I find that hard to believe.
Who would miss that?
Yeah. And the mayor of the day said, "I'm never doing one of these again." So, I mean, I got thick skin. You want to show Derek says me, that's okay. I'm okay with that.
Well, I see that. That's just an opportunity to stand in front of the people we serve and
okay.
Tell them about what we're doing, why we're doing it, bring it all back again in a...
I do not want to lose sight of the fact that I want to have a town hall meeting to tell people who are concerned that there is no future in the paper industry, that there is a huge future in the paper industry. I don't want to talk about people's garbage stands getting broken. I want to talk about Canadian craft paper in business, in the paw, for a long, long time. That's what I want. That's what I want at this town hall meeting.
Well, I think you have an agenda with specific things that we want to get out to the community, and then you have like a set aside, you know, citizens period, so that people can get up and ask questions. And
we provide two citizens periods at every meeting we have. So that's fine. I would like to call a town hall meeting so that CKBI can do a presentation and show that they're investing in this community.
So you want Canadian Craft Paper to come to this meeting and do a presentation?
Absolutely. I want them to share the report that they gave in a meeting last week that was with the province, with Growth, Enterprise, and Trade. It wasn't the first time they've made that presentation in the last couple of weeks, and I doubt it would be the last. And there's nothing in there that is secret. There's no Masonic Temple stuff going on there. It's all straight up and good news, and they want to share it with the community. They're anxious to share it with the community, and I think we can be the conduit to make that happen.
Well, so realistically, I don't even know what they need us for. We could just ask them to put on their own meeting, really.
Facilitating is what we're doing.
Well, that's exactly what we're doing, and we're a serious investor.
Yeah, no, I understand.
Should we do it before a council meeting? Because the presentation wasn't that long. It's 10, 15 minutes.
No, it's like, yeah, it could stretch up to 20 minutes at best. Yeah. I would like to rent a hall. Hmm? I'd like to have it, I would like to have it at the Legion Hall or another hall that's a fair size.
Yeah.
I think if we get into a public meeting, we have to look beyond just that one issue. I think we have to look, use it again. As I said a few minutes ago, we got to promote what we're doing and going forward. We got the Rose Avenue coming up. That's a major thing. There's major costs. It's a promotion of, it's an education about that kind of thing. The important aspect of hearing from CKPI is important to get there, but there's other things that we as council are involved with and the community's doing, and we should get it all out there once and give the people a chance. If they're having trouble with their garbage bin, well then, I don't have a problem with talking about that. But if you don't have, if you go there with a very short and open-ended meeting, you get a lot of that sidetracking. So if we go forward with one, we just have to get it organized and get a sound agenda and a plan.
Why don't we get a draft agenda? Can we ask to try and get a draft agenda together and see what
that'd be great if you guys like. Give me the direction of what you would like to see on that meeting.
So I think it's a report from Canadian craft paper we're hearing, and then like a state of the union, right?
Yeah, that didn't work.
So
what does that mean to you?
So like an update, right? So Brian's talking about the LaRose Avenue. So we have the CDC, we have the Destination Marketing Fund. We have lots of things going on.
What about them, though, is my point.
An update on them, on what's happening. What has the CDC done in the last 18 months? What has,
But who's presenting
that's
that?
That's my point. That's not
CDC
ours.
Yeah.
Well, I really think you folks are missing the idea here. I could be wrong, but I think...
Are we just not looking for the Canadian craft paper? What they're meeting? You want to promote that to the... That's all you want to do?
Yes, I want to get the message out. Okay. There's naysayers. I want to be able to take those people who are having negative thoughts about what's going on and turn that boat around. And have people have confidence in the community. It's okay to invest in your community. It's okay to go out and grow. It's okay to go and shop. It's okay to do things. I remember when George Bush, after 9/11, he told people, get on airplanes, go on holidays, do things. We are a stagnant community. And it's up to us to turn that stagnation around. And this is a golden opportunity.
Okay.
A golden opportunity.
I'm going to be blunt. I think if you advertise that we're having a town hall meeting to talk about Canadian craft paper and their 100 days and all the sunshine and lollipop things that they're going to do, you're not going to get a good turnout. Because the naysayers, they don't want to come and hear it, so they're not going to come. So you need to have other things on the agenda. Because if people have their mind made up about something, they're not going to come and listen to a presentation trying to convince them of it.
Then, yes.
Can we not just do it in council of Canadian craft paper? Sorry, my voice is going. It's going all the time.
Foolish me, I thought we'd get 100 people. You'd never get 100 people in there. It's pretty warm. I've been in there before when there's been 100, and it's not comfortable.
Well, you just want to stick to that, though.
Well, no. You know what? I'm fine. Perhaps what we could do is over the next 2 to 3 weeks, maybe send agenda suggestions to Randy, and we'll come back with a draft agenda. It might be 120 days and 130 days or something, but we'll come up with a solution to this. I just think we have a responsibility to make sure people have a true and honest picture of what's happening.
Well, so it doesn't go to 130 days before. Set a deadline and say by the next meeting have
sure.
Your agenda items in.
Okay.
So we can discuss
so,
them for the next meeting?
Sure. Mm-hmm. Let's make that sure it's an agenda item we have and suggestions are sent to you.
Yeah. And again,
suggestions
I did,
with the description.
Yes, because yeah. I did dodge that bullet because again, this is your meeting, this is your state
yeah.
address.
Yeah.
This is not mine.
Yeah.
So I want the clear direction as to what do you want to tell the public. This isn't my point.
What would you like to see on there?
That was a great shot there. But yeah,
I win.
We'll see about that.
So that needs to be a Randy by April 19th.
Are you April who?
19? April 19th. Yep.
Next Thursday.
Okay.
Right?
Next Wednesday.
Wait, we'll be sending a reminder up tomorrow to tell you that.
Okay.
Next Wednesday.
And next week, and the next week, and the next week.
One reminder.
Okay. That was fun. 4.7, the Pond District Chamber of Commerce Trade Show.
Well, we thought that wasn't as fun. Let's watch this one.
Okay.
So, we have a few that have agreed to come forward. I want to ensure that we have enough coverage for a booth the whole time. We're looking at being part of the trade show. Who's going? We need to set up a schedule with this. What do you want at your trade show booth?
The Rose
House. Council's booth.
Maybe we could have one town hall meeting at the trade show for two long days.
Presentation. Hitches for your garbage stand, so when you close the door, it closes, probably doesn't break.
Could we do examples of those there? Even like an annual, like, you
know how you have your CAO report that has all of the highlights of all the things that have been happening in the department?
Like,
could we somehow, like, comprise that into, like, an annual report? Like, this is what kind of happened over the year?
Are we still doing that State of the Union thing?
No, we're kind of, yeah,
it
looks like I'm
going to
do some
So I'm not going to be able to participate in the actual trade show when it's up, so I'd hate to say that I want to see a whole bunch of this thing and that thing and the other thing, and then I'm going to be at the CKP one, and I'm going to be helping with the Recycle Center one, so I'm just not going to be able to be at this one for at least not better than a flyby, like, oh, hey, I can hang out for 30 minutes if you want to go get something to eat.
I'm happy because I was expecting a but in there, and I thought you were going to give me a direction that has to be something in your essence.
But what would you say, Randy?
What I would say is I would probably recommend council put some thought and effort into this and come up with a plan as to what they want.
This is May long weekend.
Maybe it can be as simple as... Maybe it can be as simple as an annual report being created as a bit of a pamphlet. As opposed to having big speaking points or whatever, a 5-page pamphlet that outlines some of the activities that have gone on, some of the positives that happened in the community, that the changes that have been made over the last year. And I mean, you know, whatever, people can sit there, not me, but people could sit there and just, you know, whatever.
We talked about Lake Lots, promoting that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Maybe Wood Acres Lots.
For sure.
But, some small written materials would be probably get you a lot of traction. People aren't probably going to want to really stand there for a half an hour necessarily, or at least not a lot of them, to hear a presentation.
You're going to want to grab a pamphlet and ask a question.
How many people do we actually have participating here?
I probably can. I think I can.
Was that can or was that can't?
I think
I thought you said you could.
I thought it was May long.
No,
I thought it was May long. I might be.
What are the dates? The exact dates?
May 11th, 12th, and 13th.
11th, 12th, and 13th. Thursday, Friday, Saturday.
I cannot. I'll just say at the beginning, I cannot do during the daytime because I'll be by myself at the shop.
Yeah.
But I can do the evening, and I've got a lot of hats this week, that weekend. Got COPP, I'll be there. I'm on their recycling board, and we're going to hand out those pamphlets. And that's a great idea with the pamphlets, because I handed them out last year, and everybody just loved them. Just information, bang, bang, bang. So what even the town could do is put the list of, do you have a complaint? Here. Put it in writing.
Would be good.
Put it in writing, and then you can put your name on there, and simple as that. There's a lot of people, they do. We had it at one meeting there where they like to do their little basin, but not one of them wants to sign their name in the dotted line. And I stated it a few times. You have to fill out a form, have to sign your name, and then it's directed to the right department. Hearsay doesn't go anywhere.
So, Jen, did we already book, or were we waiting till this
we're
to
waiting.
Book? Because I want to ensure that we have coverage. If we're in this, we want to ensure
hours.
That we're covered.
Okay.
I have staff
hours.
That says they would go for bits and pieces. I'm in the same boat as you. I'm also in another booth too, so I can do both, but not the entire time.
Okay, if we can kind of do it by the chamber in the front there with the recycling, COPP in the town, then we can switch off.
Well, you know, you live in a small town, man, huh? I've got three booths, I'll be out, yeah.
So it worked really, really good last year with the COPP, and we had the Chamber of Commerce in the front, and we had a recycling board, and it went really, really well. Like, we have giveaways for the recycling board and pamphlets, and COPP, well, that's information to the public, that's given out, and then information with.
Yes. So maybe we can try make. Okay, so Andrew, you're not available.
No.
Alan, what is your schedule?
Thursday, another than that. No.
Thursday, you're available?
I'm pretty sure.
Crystal. And what works better?
Yeah, I think I could probably do like say 7 to 9 on the 11th and 12th because Jordan's at the trade show all day for the Ford booth, and then I could probably do like a 4-hour shift or something on the Saturday and just get because he'll be there on the Saturday.
Well, that's too, 8 of 19 hours right
yeah.
there. Perfect.
Excellent. Jim,
start to finish, I'll be there.
Brian,
okay. I'm available all 3 days. So.
Don't swap me in, but I can be there. I can just,
Chad?
Yeah, no, I can probably spend a little bit of time there. I can't commit to.
Is there anything that works better? Because what we'll do is we'll actually do up a schedule.
I can do Saturday during the day, so just hopefully I can get Kimberly to.
Thursday or Friday?
I'll be looking for students, too, at that.
Thursday or Friday?
Yeah.
During the day or night, day or evening.
Either.
Evening.
Yeah, whatever. I can.
Friday's it okay?
Yeah.
Yes.
Opens at 11 or something,
Friday's
doesn't it?
12 to 9.
12.
Okay. We'll be giving you a schedule.
Thank you.
The bureaucracy is in action.
Is that good? I might be able to do it.
You must have get pretty smooth at this.
You're doing great. Okay. So now, when we, of course, at the last second let you down, we're going to have staff to whoever we're going to come in and do this.
Yeah, we're having staff there.
We go.
We're going to be staggering our time, too.
Okay.
Not for the whole 19 hours.
Of course not.
Okay. Have cookies?
No, I'm just making sure.
Wait,
no,
making?
No.
You want to go sell?
All the West Canada cookies?
I don't know
what that's what I heard.
They never seem to make it out of it.
So we'll have financial plan, annual report highlight. Lake lots, wood acres lots, and maybe some complaint forms.
Yeah.
Cool.
What do we have for giveaways?
Pens.
Pins?
We have wooden pens that.
Pens and pins.
What are we gonna? What are we gonna?
Ink
draw.
Off.
Draw.
Yeah.
Lake lot.
Yeah.
Well. garbage tax.
Yeah. You know what? We that's not a bad idea. We have the carry bags, so make a little
yeah.
Swag bag.
Yeah, a town of the past bag.
Recreation and all, we can do that.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, well, let me pass.
That's
right. Does recreation have a? Does recreation have a?
No, we're gonna include them with us.
Yeah. Oh wow.
Could
we? Fire department. They're gonna be doing stuff with us.
We need two draws: one for adults and one for youth.
We yeah, talking
like rec passes. What?
Yeah. We do
for
kids
draw. Yeah, I think that'd be cool.
Yeah, for sure.
Always adult
trucks. 40 crown rolling here sounds like nothing.
Are you buying it?
No.
What
budget
line
is
that coming out?
Okay.
Yeah, he does.
He does make money.
Okay. Very good one.
Yeah. 400 bottles of it.
350 now. Yeah,
he was
over. So we have payroll period 6 and 7 in the amount of $206,574.09. General checks in the amount of $317,927.21. Electronic funds transfer in the amount of $181,601.03. A lot of these are just our regular amount of a hydro or MTS source deductions. We had bigger amounts for the airport for fuel, purchase chemical. A lot of it is just finishing up with our arena, with our propane and stuff, so there are some of your larger ticket items. And then we had our grant in $40,000 that we've given towards the library printing office.
And this is a longer period of time.
Yeah,
time
much longer.
What about, where are we at, now that the ice is out, where are we at with our leak? Have we been able to determine where that is?
No, he's waiting for the crew to come in from Winnipeg to help us out with that. I'll double check with him tomorrow to find out if he has anything new.
Okay. Okay, need a resolution to pay the bills, folks. Okay. All right. Social media versus personal freedom.
So, again, this is on, if you recall, when we had a meeting a while back, we had discussed bringing this back to the table. This was the policy that was initially brought. Just so you know, there is a social media policy that is part of the RCMP expectations. We need to ensure public sees town Facebook as town's Facebook page and that it says town representation. This was to open the discussion again as to what does council want for direction. Not everybody's always on the same page.
No,
what
true.
Are we doing? This was brought back by the request of council at a meeting we've had in the past. That is why this came back again to the table.
I thought we were finished discussing it after the last meeting.
And direction was to bring it back when Randy was here in case Randy had anything to discuss.
This is, you guys wanted it back here. If you want the social media, Scott follows it. I'll be honest with you, I've written up, like I should be honest, I'm always honest with you. I have actually written up employees with their comments on social media. This is coming quite a common thing in the workplace. Any of our accommodation seminars that we've gone to, it's becoming a thing, quite a big thing.
So this is all covered in your policies. I've read it over a few times, so we should be following what, since we are a town employee, we should be following the same thing.
These policies, it's not actually a policy though, right? It's an unopposed policy that we talked about.
So, if there's something on this policy you don't like, this is the time to let's discuss this. This was brought before and it was, we were told we don't need one. So it was like, okay, then another meeting we have, we need one. We brought it back and then it's like, let's wait for me to come back. What do you want? Do you want a policy and what do you want in it? This is your policy for the town.
Again, this is the one that the employees will that follow to.
This will, everybody will
everybody
be following
follow.
A social
okay.
media policy.
Right
now what we are doing is employees have been disciplined by information they put on their Facebook as we have kind of brought in other policies about what you talk about with your employer, making comments about your employer,
yeah,
that sort of thing.
Mm-hmm. I'm fine with the policies as they exist.
One thing I don't think is reflected here, but I know it's discussed, is that forwarding information prior to it being published through the town of social media apparatus, whatever that is.
Mm-hmm.
That I think should be included, but either way, as long as we all agree that, you know, stuff is going to come from you guys first and not from us.
Generally, what we put on social media is general updates.
Right.
That's all we get. We don't get into politics of who's doing what. We
no, but sometimes information has gone out, not through, to me, the right channels. Like, or it went out before, it went out from you guys. The Town of Paw owns the information, it should go out through the Town of Paw social media website.
Oh, okay, I see.
So it's going, it's going out there. It's not coming from me. And then, because I heard about it somewhere, and you're in the meeting, and I went and put it out before you did. It comes from you guys being the Town of Paw.
Gotcha.
So there's a structure on it, and then from there, if it needs to be shared or forwarded, that's fine. But there's one apparatus for the town to disseminate information, and that's the Town of Paw website, Facebook page, Twitter account, Snapchat, whatever your...
Instagram.
and whatever else comes out that I don't know.
I think the challenge or what's missing with regard to the policy falls under the procedure part of it, because it's the policy's fine. It was written, I think, more for employees than for mayor and council. What I find lacking is what is the procedural process with regard to when anyone on council violates the policy, because you run into a gray zone when normally the policy is, as you mentioned, when it's an employee, they fall under the CAO. When it's mayor and council, it falls under a different level of governance, and we really haven't addressed, okay, if it's a complaint against, just as, yeah, if it's a complaint against Brian Rock, Council Rock, how does council deal with me? What is that process going to be? Because it would be unfair, unless it's a clear direction of council, to assume that the CAO would, well, you deal with everybody else, therefore you should deal with Council Rock, and you will go in just a minute, because it puts you in a very difficult position. So maybe we have to review if there's a way within the procedural side of it of addressing the two levels. We're going to be talking about the organizational chart after, and there's a clear relationship there that isn't on a plane, it's a vertical.
What you're talking about, though, is a different procedure than what you're talking about is a disciplinary procedure for elected officials, which would be applicable to whatever the circumstance might be where that is a necessary thing, right? Whether it be because I posted something inappropriate on Facebook and I need to be disciplined. That doesn't really, it may stem from a policy about social media, because that's where I behave badly, but then the decision about how that gets dealt with needs to come from some kind of disciplinary procedure. But, I mean, I'm not sure that doesn't exist, and a council can discipline. So
ours falls under code conduct.
Yeah, and ours falls under, I mean, we
have... It should probably do the same almost, but there is no, real...
consequences of misconduct. Every member of council who fails to meet his or her obligations under this code is subject to censure by council.
Which means
nothing.
What? But when we met with...
censure?
What was his... Yeah, he missed me.
John.
John. He said for their council, they just agreed, right? That's where I said, these are going to be the rules. Here it is. We're agreeing to do it. And not getting to... what we're talking about now.
What his council does is they just don't talk.
They just don't talk. And that's what they agreed to do. That's fine. So if we're agreeing to say, like, this is what we're going to do, then we're going to do it. And if we don't, then we'll deal with it at that time. If we're going to spend the next 10 hours trying to figure out the procedure, if someone goes offside, then we're going to be here a long time.
Well, that's fine. But when it comes to employees, we don't say that.
But we don't have employees, right?
We have one.
Yeah. We're just talking about us, right? And these guys have been trying to formalize some of our issues and help us out. So are we going to agree to do this or something else? Then we should agree to do it. But if we're going to try to create a whole level of bureaucracy around what's going to happen if someone goes outside, then, I mean, that's 10 hours I don't have time for.
Well, because there's really nothing.
Right? Like, what do we do?
It's you basically... You're establishing a policy in hopes that everybody follows it. If someone doesn't follow it, basically, all it is shame on you, you should have followed it. Let's face it, that's the way it works.
So we have, sorry, but we have had a few conversations, I think, and again, to repeat myself, like, I think we've come to a collective understanding of what people deem appropriate and not appropriate. Alan, you echoed, you know, only share things from the Town of the Paw Facebook page, and I don't think that that has happened, you know, that has been happening. I don't think, I mean, let's face it, Jim and I are the ones that are the most active on social media, so, I mean, I don't think Jim and I have done anything but share information from the Town of the Paw page for, you know, months since you made a comment about that when it first happened. So, I mean, I think people are being respectful, and again, like, I just think it's going to be so impossible to create a policy that's going to encompass everything. And I mean, so what? So if I share an update from the Town of the Paw community page, do I still have to post the thing or whatever, like the disclaimer? Like, because I mean, I already have a disclaimer. When we talked about it months and months and months ago when it first came up, I put the disclaimer on my page, so it's there.
I think
clicking. Stop clicking, please. Oh. I can't stop it.
Oh, someone's clicking.
Oh, clicking.
Hands clicking.
I'm in to click.
I think we're all rational and logical adults, and I think if we are able to,
sorry.
I think if we're able to agree to something as adults, I think that we could all probably abide by it, and I think. I don't think we need to go through the whole setting a policy that doesn't really matter at the end of the day anyway. So
the only thing I would ask as CAO is please lead by example. If I'm going to be disciplining my employees, keep in mind that it would be expected. There's an expectation for me to lead by example to them, and I would expect the same.
Yes. Okay. Absolutely.
Not saying anything that anybody's doing anything wrong.
No.
My point being, always remember that we have employees that will be paying attention to this as mm-hmm. they have that policy to follow.
Okay.
So we're not moving forward with this suggested policy.
That's what I'm
procedure?
Hearing.
We're not?
I thought we are.
You don't say
I thought we are.
We are.
I am not going to post on my, I'll go to court. I'm not going to say the postings of this site are my own and may not represent the Town of the Paw's position, strategies, or opinions. I'm not putting that at the start of anything I post about the town. People ask me all the time about that. I'm not doing that.
But if we as a council agree that's our policy, then I guess. All right. Well,
censor.
I mean, that's up to you.
I'm not doing that.
That's why, and I believe that's why this has come back to the table, because this council has not agreed on it.
I'll say it one more time, I won't say it again. I live in Canada. I have freedoms, and no one is going to tell me I need to start my post off with 21 words.
I don't know how many words are there. Did you count them?
I did.
Well, bring it forward into regulation and
there you go.
Go forward and go from there.
Right. Bring it forward.
Do you want to go that route? Is that what we want to do?
Well, it's not up to
you. This far, so let's make a put it into an environment where we can decide yes or no.
We decided 2 weeks ago we weren't doing this and that we were just bringing it back in case Randy had some concerns. That's what we did. That's what we came to a conclusion. And now we're right back where we were at the beginning.
I disagree with that, Jim. I think it's brought forward, right? Like, you said the same thing last time. You didn't want to do it. So, Jen said you, I think, if correct me if I'm wrong, you felt more comfortable if Randy was here, right? So here we are.
Okay.
So, are we going to do it? Yes or no? Like, was it crap or get off the pot?
That's all I'm asking.
Yeah.
Either way, we will follow. I don't have an opinion either way with this. This is your policy as members of council. I just want an answer to know that in 2 months' time, I'm not bringing this back again.
Yeah, no.
If council wishes to proceed, that's great. If council wishes not to proceed, that's great.
So we should vote now and say, do we want to move forward with this or not?
We cannot
vote.
Yeah,
no, but do you?
I say create
yes,
the
right,
let's bring it up.
There you go.
Let's bring it forward.
So can we do a straw poll to see if we want to bring it forward? Is that right?
Yeah, that's right. No,
I guess I'm jumping in here. Ask the question, do we want a policy? Yes or no? If we do want a policy, do we want it to be this policy or do we want to have something different? That's all I'm looking for.
Yeah, and I would, so to proviso that, or not proviso, but to bookend that, right? You only, we make policies should be made when policies are needed. Policies are typically needed when you have common situations that tend to occur over and over again where you need to have clear and consistent decision making with respect to what happens, how you react to action A, typically using action B or whatever. So, I mean, that's the first question, is there enough, not just action on social media, but misaction, or is there enough evidence to support that this is really a problem? I mean, is it really a problem? I don't know. I've been here for six. I don't have a problem with the policy as it's written, personally. But my question is, 6 years I've been sitting here. Facebook's been around for 12. Has it really been a problem? Has it been the odd time where an issue crops up because somebody doesn't like something that's happened? Yeah. Did that happen prior to Facebook's existence and all this other stuff? Yeah. I'm sure that when there were elected officials and mayors and councils, somebody would go to a coffee shop somewhere and spout off as the councillor or as the mayor about something that wasn't actually what was talked about at a meeting or whatever. And you could policy that right out the door if you want, but it's not going to really change what goes on. So I'm not a fan of policies for the sake of policies. I'm a fan of policies if they're actually going to address an issue. For that to be the case, an issue actually has to exist. I'm not necessarily convinced that an issue actually exists, at least not one that can be managed through a policy. You can't manage my personality through policy. I don't go on Facebook. It's my personality. I just don't, so I don't post. So it's not really an issue for me. But if you were going to pass a policy that said I had to have a Facebook account because I'm a counselor, and that I have to put on there that it has to have this and it has to have that, I'd say, no, I don't have to do that at all. It's not why I was elected. I was elected to make decisions. So, I mean, I struggle with whether or not this is actually a policy that's applicable and that can be useful to us. That's my problem with this thing. So for me personally, I don't think I can support it. Not because I don't believe it's not necessarily a good idea, but I don't think the situation has evolved enough. I don't think the issue is well-rounded enough. And I think we will find ourselves passing a policy and a procedure, finding ourselves at fault somehow in amongst it, and not on purpose, but through whatever, and then we'll be dealing with another scenario where we're wasting another hour talking about trying to fix a policy that shouldn't exist perhaps in the first place because it isn't necessarily an issue. Is there a way to discipline elected officials should I misbehave? No, not really. Unless you get a court to throw me out, I'm here, and I'm here for four years unless I choose to leave. Unless there's whatever those two things are that can happen that get me out of here, unless they happen, that's it. You can make policies through the roof. You could say, you know, I mean, whatever. But so I struggle with it. I don't think I can support it. Not because I don't think it's well-intentioned. I just don't think it's functional.
But you guys want to know whether we're moving forward.
That's it. Just tell me yes or no.
So I heard Andrew say no. I'm saying no. He didn't say no. So
I said yes. But
I don't think we need to move forward.
So I'm hearing four.
There you go. We're done. So we're not talking about it anymore.
No.
It's not allowed to bring it up for
you. As Randy said, we're going to leave by
again,
example.
Just like, well, I'll repeat what I said earlier, just be mindful of everybody, not saying just council, everybody be mindful of what you're putting on posts as I deal with it through my day-to-day operations too, and we lead by example.
And I think one of the things, I mean, we should all be accountable to each other and help to hold each other accountable. So if people see that councillors, fellow councillors, or the mayor for that matter, is posting something that maybe you don't agree with or you think is disrespectful or is not something, you know, that we discussed and we have agreed that's appropriate, like call people out on it. Like that's what we're here for.
I feel like
keep
that's
each other in line, who's gonna do it?
I feel
it's
like
it's not a fun thing to do, but if we don't keep each other in line, like who's gonna do it, right? Like if I don't know that something I posted offended you, I might have thought it was okay, right? Like
No, I'm not arguing that. I just thought, bring it out on Facebook.
Well, no, I mean, obviously in an appropriate way and in a respectful way, we've sat through a session with a mediator. I think we're all grown adults and that we would be able to have a respectful conversation around something, right?
If I may suggest, 5.2, organizational chart.
Sure.
Just one last question on this one. this was the proposed changes too.
Mm-hmm.
My only question
no,
is...
No,
is
that right, was never one. A policy or procedure. That would have been a whole
new one. This is a brand new, so we don't have any standing.
Correct.
it falls under the code of conduct.
Social media.
Where I go through hours is code of ethics or code of conduct. That's the policy I use when disciplining employees. And it's very specific to in there. Like it's, you know, publicly, that's how I get it, is through the publicly humiliating your employer or anything like that, right? Or having a negative impact on your employer.
Okay. So this goes in the wastebasket.
Yep.
It's not a...
Yeah.
Okay, that's good.
Organizational chart.
There was just a few minor changes in it. I know, Alan, you had asked why we have parallel right now. This was part of our whole new organization move around, getting rid of positions that are no longer being used. Right now, we do have the maintenance and the public works department at level. And what it is until we get that 100% like together, I have them at level. Those two, as managers, work together. They manage their own crews. Until we get a little better feel on how we're going to utilize both crews, then we'll be looking at changing the way the document is. That makes sense?
Mm-hmm. That imply, my point was that everything seems to be working fine.
Mm-hmm.
People change different personalities, so if there's an opportunity to structure it, like you say,
sure.
We'll take it. But there was another,
change
yeah, you'll change that. The way it's drawn is that we have 10 employees and not just one.
Yeah.
No one wants that. So there's one line.
I didn't understand what you meant by that, so now I see that.
I just don't understand it too.
Yeah. That's the way it was. I think it was just a matter of the box.
So what is it you would like us to do with this chart then? Okay, by resolution then we can do that? Is that an issue with that, Brian?
I'm just wondering, where's the library?
Is that part of ours?
It's not part.
They're not town employees.
They're not part of library.
But the museum...
Yep, is under us. Which is something we probably in the future need to be talking about.
We really do.
Yep.
We really do.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, so, okay.
Yeah.
That's what I need.
Yep.
I was assuming it ran under a board and it didn't run under the town.
I don't understand how that works.
Like kind of like the public Kelsey Rec Commission was set up, right? How they still have their own commission/board, if you will, but they were still a department and fell
into the 50-year-old light bulb went off and said we should probably get
watch
them. But the reason why we're shrinking up the same date was when Sam Waller passed away, in his will, he gave the museum to the town of the park.
No way.
Yeah.
Really?
That's what happened. This is all part of the whole, like, yeah, we got a good education on it. And it was basically, that was part of his will, that it's left to the town of the pond, that it's run out of the way it does now.
No way.
Yeah.
That's cool.
UND.
What's that?
UND. Change the name of the team, that's to go to
hockey.
That was the deal.
I'm not going to make a dead man upset.
Deputy Mayor, noticing camera, please.
Oh, what did I get for?